So hello everyone, my name is André Dolenz and I'm a software engineer here at Devisoft, and I'm going to be your guide through this C++ script webinar. So what is this webinar going to look like? Well, first of all, we're going to get to the same level. I'm going to be telling you what C++ script actually is. Then I'm going to give you a bunch of motivational examples or cool stuff that we use C++ script for. And because I absolutely hate PowerPoints, we're just going to do live demos, okay, for a bunch of this. Then after that, we're going to write a script together. Then I'm briefly going to talk about exporting your scripts that you write. And then after that, if you're still interested in C++ script, if I at all have motivated you during this webinar, then I'm going to refer you to a bunch of other sources where you can learn more about C++ script. Because unfortunately, in this webinar, I'm not going to have enough time to teach you absolutely everything there is to know about C++ script. So instead, what I want to focus on in this webinar, what the takeaway from this should be maybe, is that it should give you an overview of all the different use cases for C++ script that you've been able to find. And maybe it should show you the versatility of C++ script. And then you can maybe start thinking about whether or not C++ script can actually be used to solve your problems as well. So with that, maybe let's just begin with the introduction. So the first question that pops to mind, right, is what is C++ script? And a one sentence answer would be that C++ script is basically just a tool inside Devisoft to create custom math modules, right? It uses C++ as the programming language in the background. And the very best thing about C++ script is that to create new modules, you don't actually have to ever leave Devisoft. You don't have to close it or anything like that. So mentioning C++ as the programming language might sound a bit intimidating. And while C++ provides us with a lot of power, as you're going to be able to hopefully see, one of the main focuses in this while developing C++ script has been given to make it as simple to use as possible. So the simplicity of use really was the primary focus. And hopefully I'm able to show you that throughout these examples that are going to follow. So with that, maybe let's just go to a bunch of motivational examples. And with the examples, I'm not going to be showing you any real details of how the C++ scripts that I'm going to show you work, or I'm not going to go into any details at all, but I'm going to give you a brief overview of what they do. And then my main point here is basically just to show you how versatile C++ script actually can be. So with that, let me just alt-tab into my Devisoft, and that is a bit embarrassing. I have forgot to close this snake game that I was playing earlier during my preparation for this webinar, so let me just close this real quick. You know what? This snake was actually written in C++ script. So maybe this can be our first motivational example. So let's go into channel setup and see how it was made, okay? So in channel setup, under math, you can see that I have this C++ script math module. It's called snake version 1.0.0. And if I open up this setup for this script, you can see that I've got a bunch of settings that I can define for this module. So I've got screen width and screen height, which define the size of my playing area. And I've got snake speed, which defines the speed of my snake, right? And on the top left-hand side of my setup menu, I've got some input channels. In the bottom left, I've got some output channels. And these output channels actually might give you a hint of how it was done, right? This screen is basically just a 2D matrix that I am drawing onto a 3D plot later on as my game is updating. So I'm refreshing it every time my game updates. And this looks quite a bit similar to other setup screens of other math modules, right? And in fact, let me go a step further and let me open this script up for you. By clicking on this log button, I actually opened up four different tabs here. And these four tabs are basically the main tabs for C++ script. But what I'm only interested in right now is this code editor tab. So this is basically where all the code lives for this C++ module. And you can see that while it's quite a bit of code, it's actually only 160 lines of code in the end. So it's really not a lot of lines of code for what it does, right? We can play perfect games of Snake here. Imagine doing something like this in some other way, for example, with a plugin system, right? Using our plugin system, it would take you a bunch more lines of code to write something similar to this, and it would take you maybe a day or two to write and debug. But here in C++ script, I was able to write this completely from scratch in about 2 hours, maybe. So that's a great example, maybe, of how simple C++ script can actually be. But let me move on to actual examples of real-world use that we were able to find with the C++ script. So let me open up this setup, and let me maybe just quickly guide you through what I have here on the screen. So the first thing I have is on the top left corner, I've got this yellow signal over here. It doesn't matter right now what the signal is, it's just some signal. And on the top right corner, I'm basically plotting up the Fourier transform of this yellow signal. So this is this yellow curve that's jumping around over here, right? Now, on the bottom left, I've got a 3D graph control, and I'm plotting this yellow curve. Every time it updates, I'm plotting it onto this 3D graph control, and I basically get a nice visualization of what my Fourier transforms of this yellow signal look throughout time, right? So the new signal, the new curves are fitted onto the right-hand side of this plot, and everything shifts a bit to the left, and this creates this nice waterfall effect. So what we had a lot of requests for is basically that this waterfall is beautiful and all, but it doesn't really give you a nice overview over longer time periods of time. So this is actually, a C++ script is perfect for something like this. In fact, here on the top right, I've got also this orange curve now. And this orange curve is just taking a snapshot of this yellow curve every 2 seconds. I made it 2 seconds for the purposes of this webinar, but you could think about it that it could be 10 minutes or half an hour, or maybe we could even talk about days, right? So every time this orange curve gets updated, I actually plot it the same onto this bottom right waterfall. And you can see that I get a much more condensed look as to what my FFTs look throughout the time. So if I go into channel setup and again show you how this script was made, it's actually, again, I've got this setup form where I can say, for example, 10 minutes instead of 2 seconds. And now I'll get an FFT every 10 minutes, right? So you could hack this up together with a formula and an asynchronous channel and so forth and so forth and a bunch of nasty hacks. But I hope you agree that this is a much nicer end user interface where you can just say, I want a sample every 10 minutes and that's it. And if we look into the brains of this module, you can see it's actually even shorter than the first one, a lot shorter. It's actually just 48 lines of code. And in fact, this was actually created by one of our student programmers when she first came to Devesoft. And she didn't know anything about C++ script, and she had only passing knowledge of Devesoft at the time, but she was able to come up with something like this in a matter of hours, so in a matter of maybe half a day. So you can see that it's very simple to use. And back then even, she didn't really have the resources for teaching C++ script that we have now. So maybe hopefully that really tells you how simple it is to solve some problems that Devesoft might have internally. And in fact, let me move on to a second motivating example here. It's actually this signal right here. So this is not being generated in real time as we go, and it's not being played back by a measurement device or anything like that. This is in fact just a text file that I have on my hard drive that looks like this. It's just a bunch of numbers, one number per line. And I have a C++ script in the background that's able to take this text file, load it from disk, and then fill it one sample at a time into this output channel. So the way this looks is basically, if we open it up, so the problem with this was that, yes, we have a file replay plugin inside Devesoft. However, the problem with that file replay plugin is that you cannot use it alongside doing real measurement. So those two are mutually exclusive. So if you want to do real measurement, there was no real way of doing that up until now, because now we have this C++ script where I can basically just point the C++ script to the file that I want to be my source. And then if I look into the code editor, this is actually 48 lines of code, but it's way too much code for this even, because it's doing all the nice checking if everything exists and everything like that. So again, it's just 48 lines of code of very readable C++ code that you show to any programmer and he's going to be able to pretty much understand what's going on. So I don't really have any more motivating examples to show you, but I do have a couple of anecdotes that I want to share. So I was one of the main engineers developing the new combustion engine analyzer module for the past half a year or so. And in the new combustion analyzer, we had a bunch of algorithms that we wanted to implement, but we weren't really sure about the details of how this algorithm should look like. So we had the choice, right? I could have implemented these algorithms inside Davisoft, and I could have spent waste directly in Davisoft and spent maybe a couple of days trying to figure out all the details. But on the other hand, I had some data files that I could use to compare the algorithms against and results against. So it was really tedious for me to maybe do the same tinkering in Python, because I would have to figure out how to export all the data into Python or in MATLAB or whatever and to do the programming there. So instead, what I did was I actually used C++ script to develop them. And using the C++ script, I was able to prototype these algorithms, figure out all the details within maybe half a day again, and share it with engineers that actually know about this stuff. And they were able to confirm it very quickly that something is correct or something is not correct. And C++ script, I just want to tell you, is absolutely perfect for quick prototyping of some ideas that you might have. Another use case for C++ script could be the new cursor module in the SP5 that we just released. So the cursor module is absolutely brilliant. It has all these nice visual markers for the different events and so forth, and you have visual controls where you can move between events and so forth. But it actually took one of our main engineers a couple of weeks to properly write inside Davisoft. On the other hand, C++ script was actually used to first prototype this same cursor module. And it was prototyped again in a couple of hours from the very beginning with the idea to the end with the nice prototype. And this prototype could even also be almost be used in real world. But we wanted to go a bit further and add some nice visualizations and so forth and so forth. In fact, speaking about this, a lot of people internally here at Davisoft are actually using C++ script to test their own modules or to generate test signals for their own module, because C++ script is just great for doing that. You can very quickly create your own test modules, test signals for testing your modules. So in fact, speaking about creating your own, let's actually create one C++ script together, just so you can get an idea of how simple it actually is to create a fresh C++ script. So let me just go back into Davisoft, and let me open up this setup file that I have here. This is just a setup file that has this one signal here that I'm generating on the fly. And creating a new C++ script is basically as simple as clicking on add math and clicking on C++ script that's next to the formula. A familiar, at least semi-familiar setup opens up with four tabs at the top. And we're going to walk through all of these four tabs when we're creating a new C++ script. So the first tab that we're actually interested in is this project tab. Here you can define what your module is going to be called and what the description is going to be and so forth and so forth. So I haven't told you about what we're actually going to do yet. So let me just briefly touch on that. What I thought about doing is basically we could take an input signal, split it into blocks of 100 samples at a time, and then for each of those blocks, we could find the maximum value in that block and then use that as an output of our script. So it would kind of search for maximum on a per block basis of input signal. So let's call our project per block max, and then let's give it a description of find maximum of a signal on a per block per every 100 consecutive samples, because we're gonna be looking at 100 samples at a time inside our blocks. And then let's fill in the developer first and last name. So my name is Andrei Dolenz, and my email for email I'm just gonna put in my support at davisoft.com. That's great. And then I don't want to really lose any more time on this project tab. So let's move on to the configure tab. And in configure tab, here we basically define what our C++ script is going to, how it's going to behave. So the first thing that we can actually set is set the calculation call to be from sample-based to block-based, because we're going to be, again, taking 100 samples at a time and then finding the maximum of those 100 samples. So let's change the block size to 100. And then down below, we have four additional tabs. Now, in the first tab, we could define a bunch of settings that are going to appear in the right-hand side of the setup form at the end when we create our module for the end user to use. But let's just move on to the input channels, because we're not going to have any variables that the user can define here. So for the input channels, let's click on this plus to add an input channel. And this form opens up, where we basically have to define two names. The first name is C++ variable name, is the way we are able to refer to this channel from inside the C++ script. So let's just call this in. And for publish name is how the end user is going to see this channel on the outside. So let's call it imp, the same just for this input channel. It doesn't really matter. The input channel is going to be a real scalar, and it's going to be either a synchronous channel or asynchronous channel. It really doesn't matter in our case. Now, if you don't know what I'm talking about here, don't worry about it. I'm going to refer you to a bunch of really nice sources that explain this very well. But for the purposes of this webinar, you don't really have to know about all this stuff. So for the output channels, we're going to have one output channel where we're going to put this maximum of each block into, and let's call it, from C++, we're going to refer to it as out, and in published name, so on the outside world, we're going to know it as max. For maximum. So it's this channel is going to be real scalar, and in this case it has to be asynchronous channel, because we're going to be outputting one sample per a block of 100 samples at a time. So we're done with this. Let's click OK, and let's move on to the code editor. So code editor is basically where the brains of your C++ module live. First of all, up here you have a class module, which is the main module that we have to fill in with our logic. And this module comes predefined with a bunch of methods C++ actually works is DevSoft is going to call these methods at relevant times. So for example, for the start method, DevSoft is going to call this start method whenever user starts a new measurement. Or for this calculate method, this is going to be called every time we have, in our case, because we set it to 100 samples at a time, whenever we have 100 new samples waiting for us in the input channel. So with that said, let's move all the way down and fill in the blanks, fill this program with our logic. So inside calculate, we're going to be calculating this maximum of blocks, right? So let's create a temporary variable that's going to hold our result, and let's initialize it to some really negative number. And then we're going to have to loop through all these 100 samples at a time, right? So in C++, you do it with the for loop, 0. And then what we do is, for each of these new samples that we're gonna check, we're gonna set the result variable to be the maximum of either the current result or the result that we read from the input channel. And we call this input channel imp inside configure tab, right? So imp.getScalar. At position I inside this block. And that's really all there is to it for figuring out what the maximum is going to be. But we still have to output this maximum into the output channel, right? So how we do that is basically just say out.addScalar res. And that's gonna output this res scalar, whatever we calculated, into the output channel. And that's it. On the bottom here, if I type a bit more, you can see that it's doing some real-time recompiling of the code. So every time I type something in, it actually tells me if I screwed anything up or if I'm doing perfectly well. And so everything gets compiled in real time. So, but this is all our logic that we're gonna need. So let's move on to the published setup tab. And in published setup, we don't really have very much because we define no settings, but we do have this one input signal, which we can check. And on the bottom, we've got this output channels. First, it's this debug channel, which we completely ignore. But we also have this signal max, which is going to contain our maximum value. So let's change the color to some bright blue, maybe, just so it comes out on the webinar. Let's click OK and let's test our module. So let's go to measure and let me put in signal max on top of this signal. And we can see that it kind of works, right? It seems like it's working. So it's basically calculating the maximum of the past 100 blocks or so. So let's go to channel setup, because this we can really easily check if this is actually correct or not. Because what we did is we can use basic statistics and check this maximum and make it sample based with 100 samples at a time. And we're gonna color this in some brighter red, just for comparison. And if we did everything correctly, right, it should make sense that these two signals overlap each other completely. So let's go back to measure and let me add this red signal up. So this is the output of the basic statistics module. And if I zoom in maybe a little bit more, you can see that if I move these signals up and down in the priority queue, you can actually see that these signals overlap perfectly. So this means that our module actually works. So let me just recap that for you. In what is 4 lines of code, we were able to replicate something that comes built into Devesoft. So that's pretty amazing, right? Now, of course, we didn't cover all the edge cases, or we didn't implement the entire basics module with just these 4 lines of code. But we were able to come pretty far with just 4 lines of code. I hope you agree with me at least on that. And in fact, what we did here might actually prove to be useful, right? We might actually want to use this in other setups as well. So here is where bundle exporting comes in. You can click on this export bundle on top of the project tab, and it's going to open up this settings form for you. And here we can select what our bundle type is going to be. In our case, let's just leave it as open source. Let's click OK. And this actually now, if I click save, is going to export something called the .cbu bundle file. And the absolute best thing about these CBU bundle files is that if I add it into bin add-ons folder of my Devesoft installation, Devesoft is actually going to be able to pick this custom MAT module up, and you're going to be able to use it exactly as a regular MAT module. So I've already exported this, but let me just briefly show you what I'm talking about here. If I go to another setup, so this setup right here, which has another signal again, just some signal that I generate, I can click on this add MAT button here. And over here, you can see under custom C++ scripts, I've got this per block max with exactly my description down here. So this is exactly my my custom mathematics that we just created. So I can click on this. I can click on signal. So that signal is my input to my into my mathematics. And then maybe make it the blue color again for the signal. And then if I go into measure and overlay the signal on top of this other signal, you can see that it's basically working as you would expect it to work, right? It's getting the maximum of this yellow signal and outputting it out into this other channel. So that's, I think that's really, really cool. And in fact, this bundle export was one of the main reasons why we actually started talking about creating a web store where not too dissimilar to Apple Store, where users could actually share their own custom scripts among themselves. In fact, if we're talking about the web store, we should be talking about licensing a bit, right? Because what we also did was that basically you can add licensing on a per script basis now. Now this is going to be live with the web store, but this seems like a very promising idea because the C++ scripts, the custom MAT modules are so easy to create that anyone pretty much can make them, and they can be really useful for other users as well. Now, since we're talking about licensing, let me just briefly tell you that C++ script is going to be released with the X3 SP6, which is in March of 2019. And it is going to be a paid option, meaning that you will need a license to develop your own custom scripts. On the other hand, however, you'll be able to use custom C++ scripts that other people have developed for free, provided they're not licensed, of course. So with that, maybe let me just switch back into my presentation. So, in case I didn't scare you off completely, Of course, I completely breezed through a lot of details about C++ script. And the best place where I would recommend you go to learn more about C++ script is actually the C++ script pro training that we created. And let me just open it up for you. It's on the pro training platform. We have the C++ script now. And this basically guides you through creating a C++ script completely from scratch and tells you about a bunch of different pitfalls that you might encounter while you're developing your own C++ script. So if you do this pro training, you'll be able to create your own C++ scripts with pretty big ease. On the other hand, this pro training is not gonna teach you absolutely everything there is to know about C++ script, right? So another place where you might want to go is this C++ script manual. And this will have absolutely everything there is to know about C++ script. So you're gonna have all the details, what everything is inside C++ script and so forth. Another place you might want to go to is this example bundles. We have created a bunch of example bundles for you, which are all open source, and you can peek into them and see how they work. And maybe this is a great teaching tool for you to learn how to write your own C++ scripts. Maybe you just need to modify some bundle a bit to get what you want. And the last place which I would refer you to is this developers portal that we created. So this developers portal is basically our clone of Stack Overflow, which, in case you don't know about that, is basically just a place where developers can ask other developers questions and get answers by other developers as well. And then everyone can vote on which answers are the best and so forth, and everyone basically wins at the end. So this developers portal can be found on developer.dsf.com, and hopefully this is from now on filled in with a bunch of questions about C++ script. So with that, I would thank you very much for your attention. I hope I was able to show you that C++ script is very simple to use, that it's very powerful, and I hope I was able to get you thinking maybe about which problems it might solve for you. So thank you very much.